Hey there guys, so I've been I'm gonna try something different. I set audio quality to high, so we'll see how that works out. And we've got our new crit chance item we got from the last run, so it's basically like Infinity Edge but in our darker purpose, so our crits do more damage. So I'm gonna be looking to see if I can find myself a gold star or something. That'd be pretty good. I get out of this room. Oh no! Dude, screw this room. Especially when you have a champion! Get out of here! Okay, he died. Alright, so I think I'm gonna pick up this item. Not sure what it does. Take 2 damage per pickup. Wow, that's really bad. Why would I do that? Alright, whatever. I'll just take some damage, I suppose. So I got some dodge. I'm pretty sure that doesn't really affect the tokens, though. I think that's just every time. Time after time. Oh, I should have picked these up earlier. Although, yeah. I'm not entirely certain if the token upgrade is like actually good or not. But the thing is that the 2 damage is static, it's not a percentage. So, if I get more health, it won't hurt me. But if I do end up getting the token upgrade, it'll just be, well, it won't be straight up an upgrade, because it'll depend on what my max health is. Aw man, I went all this way because I thought the boss would be there. Alright, there's a chest. Aw man, it's hard to predict when these guys are gonna shoot. Spray again. I'll just wait for a couple more rounds of this. Yeah, I'll fight this guy and then I can use the juice box upgrade. I'm not gonna hit her in this phase, I'll just wait for her to be done. I just gotta remember. Oh man, these chalk clouds. I also found out that Cordy has 5% natural crit chance. So even if I don't end up getting any crit chance, it should be pretty good. Good to go. Let's just see what's down this way. So it's kind of a waste of time, but we do get some experience, which is always good. I don't know if I mentioned it, but the sound quality is high, so we'll see if that helps or not. I already have the video quality set to high from earlier episodes, so we'll see, you know, production values. Without using juice. Oh, that's actually good, but it's also a merit item, so I don't really like using those. I wonder why some furniture is stronger than others. Like some of them don't get killed by the balls, but other ones do. We're gonna go with Gluttonous just because of the token arguably upgrade. That's also arguably a downgrade. So I can talk about what I did in real life today. So I turned in my business paper, and it was very bad. So we'll see what we get. Don't worry about us. Just a sack of potatoes. Alright. What was I saying? Oh yeah, I turned in my work and it was just straight up garbage. But it has the word count. Oh man. Nah, this isn't one of the lifesteal ones, this is just plus experience. It's one of those items that's like, it's good, but I don't really want it. Okay. I think... Nah. It's this way? I'm bad. Hey. Got a pretty good item. This is a pretty good start. I just wish tokens wouldn't kill me. I got 5. So I probably won't be able to buy anything this floor. Cauldron of Yesterday's. Oh man. I love bubbles because you don't even have to aim at these guys. Guessing down. Like it. Do. No! That seems like too much HP. Yeah, it's like 3 hits he just regened. Oh shoot. Aw man. Maybe if I just like go up here. It's like, if only they didn't bounce, this would be a way easier fight. Oh my god, dude. This is ridiculous. He should be dead. Oh my gosh. Okay, he's finally dead. So let's wait till this area clears out. And by that I mean just roll in. What? I didn't even see anything moving. You guys see those insane dodges? Man, I'm just not getting any good level ups lately. But I think I did get 2 level ups on this floor. Wow, dude, so many juice boxes. They say you always get juice boxes when you don't need them. No one says that. I can hit you, but you can't hit me. Can you walk somewhere? Yeah. Ah, this is one of the things I want. Super unlucky. I don't think I found a single token. Maybe I shouldn't have done gluttonous, because if I had just done a normal one, there probably would have been a higher probability of tokens. I guess I just thought I'd get like 2 of them, you know. Oh man. I mean, I feel like the extra items is really what I need right now, so I'll do the extra champion spawns. Oh god! The freaking drums, the radius is like always bigger than I think it will be. Wait, bubbles trigger it. I've heard that dialogue before, it's just basically about the boss I just fought. Oh man. are these guys getting hit by bubbles? I should probably invest in some attack speed. Cause that'd mean more bubble spawns. Oh sh. Okay. The easy way to do this, you just gotta kinda move slowly. Wow, did I not kill any of them? Oh wow, that's pretty sweet. I don't think I've gotten this item or the token item before. There's... Aw, it's not Tabula Rosa, unfortunately. So I think this is Goneril. And instantly proven wrong. But I do have the perfect item to deal with this guy. Cause he can... Oh wait, I guess rolling doesn't... Wow, it doesn't count as standing still. This guy's scary cause you never know when he's gonna strike. Oh my... I think literally the same exact spot is where I took damage on another run. That was just terrible on my part. By the way, I hit a milestone today, one subscriber. So thanks to whoever that is. Probably my sister. Oh my, so bad. Unsubscribe, seriously. That was pretty terrible. Oh man. What? It's like, it waits until it's like a second after when I think it would. No more taking damage. I really like both of those. So that's kind of a shame. But look at that, pretty much back to full. But I think definitely health is gonna be important considering the Oof. To be honest, I should just save my money, like. Heard Reagan got in trouble. Really? She let a few things in that were supposed to stay outside. Like birds? We think outside is a more existential meaning. By the way, this is sponsored by Pepsi. Pepsi, you'll love the way we Pepsi. No, it's not, I'm just drinking some right now. Alright, this fire is really annoying. Ourselves for money. Man, this game's so realistic, but Aw man, I have enough money for it. Should I get it? I don't know. I'll tell you what, I'll make a wager. If this guy gives us Sudsy's ice tray, then we have to buy it. So, that is not Sudsy's ice tray. Oh fuck, no. Don't die. Don't die, buddy. I need you for money. Alright, I don't need you anymore. Time to die. Let's see how much damage I take on this room. Okay, so I didn't get hit at all, and I took... Whoa, look at that amount of money. The items are so good, but... gotta actually save so I don't end up wanting stuff and then just not having any money. Don't come near here. Okay, looks like this guy's still alive. Don't. Hey, another champion spawn. Wait, that hit me? I dispute that. Plus range. I think I should be able to just use that. Oh no, is there chairs? No, there's... So this one's actually not too bad. You basically just stand here. And then on the next one, we go trigger these hands. Oh no. Gonna get me out of there. That was... Look how many freaking juice boxes are on this floor. It's pretty ridiculous. I should probably end up with pretty good health late game, considering the juice box upgrade I got. Wait, can you kill, can you kill this guy? Go kill this guy. Yeah, there we go. These guys are actually the nicest enemies in the game. Wait, how did you die? Ah! Flabbergasted is what I am. Well, I have 5 chalk, so that's probably never gonna be used. That's the best part, is when you kill an enemy before they even shoot at you. Oh man, though, this guy. I don't need you for anything. I'll just fight. I think last time I just killed this one first and that ended up being a pretty good idea. Ah, fuck. Man, that took a while to die for some reason. Oh, yeah, I knew I was gonna take damage there because I was in a corner. Fight music sounds weirdly like Final Fantasy. You guys hear that? Oh man. Hey, I just saw your item. I left it because it was useless, but, you know. I hate electricity attacks. I think? Yeah, you can kind of trick her into not using it if you just go around. I don't know why I'm dealing half damage right now. Oh man. You're dead. You don't even know it, but you're dead. And that did one damage. Alright, we got that extra damage. So yeah, I kinda hate this item because it makes me feel bad for using the vending machines. But if we just spend it on like essentials, like dodge chant and stuff, it shouldn't affect us too much. Like here, there's nothing I really want. This is semi-tempting, but that's about it. I don't know, I like never get this. I should splurge. It's 25% of 141. It should be around 30. Wait, what's the difference between these two? Docks? I should probably go with gluttonous. Aw man, I like forgot that guy even existed. He's been gone so long. See, he's going right again. Is there a max of tokens, I wonder? Alright, we found the secret room pretty quickly here. Although I think it's called Memory Room in this version of the Binding of Isaac mod, XD. Hey, I got the item from earlier I didn't buy. Oh man, that hurt my ears. So there's an achievement where you don't go in a time bubble, but it's kind of impossible because I always go in time bubbles. Do you see that? How is it possible? Like, it legit sprouts up when you're walking somewhere. Oh, look at that. Damage, boys. Did I just speed through that whole section? What the fuck? You guys see that? Oh my freaking gosh. Alright, that ending was pretty strange. Wow. So many tokens here. Oh, frick this guy, dude. You gotta time your rolls perfectly. So now I will have two rolling actives. So we'll see how this works out. Looks pretty nice. I think this will just be one of those ones. Yep, chairs. The green light bullets. Much as walk in a random direction, and poof! And I ended up getting that item anyways. Man, look at my juice box capacity. I'm pretty sure I should be able to get through that hole. Oh, I'm regenning HP already from Shy Stella. I'll come back for that later. Oh my, what? Why did I forget that goes through stuff? Oh my gosh, dude. Matrix. potatoes on three were yelling again. Indeed, sir. I could hardly sleep. Potatoes, I say. One does sympathize, sir. Those tubers are barbarians with roots. No matter how many times I see that, it never gets old. By the way, earlier when I said I was drinking Pepsi, I lied to you. I'm drinking root beer. I'm too poor for Pepsi. Now, the best soda is Dr. Pepper. And you guys all know that. I was actually planning on, That's a weird noise. I feel like this is worth. So now I'm gonna have, like, no damage, but whatever. Oh my, what? That's a cat! Why is it here, though? Give me an item. I keep thinking this piece of paper is a coin. Looks exactly like one. This run's going way better than most of my runs. The administrators are up to something. They have a more opaque ambition, sir. Not exactly more evil than that. They have a crueler motivation, sir. No, not that either, too direct. They have a more nefarious intent, sir? Those are clunky, though. They have a gloomier desire, sir. Nah, last one was better, but more nefarious is too many words. Would sir prefer the word nefarious, sir? Yes, quite. This game shall be called their nefarious intent. Very good, sir. And so it was decided. What if I just went back and I changed all the video titles to our nefarious or intent. That is quite the mouthful. Ah, what a hard decision. I'll go with wealthy. So that's interesting. I think that, she waited until right when I start firing the shield. I think that those guys over there only spawn when, after a certain amount of time has passed. Stop. Man, I am making some bank right here. I need a doctor's note. They say it would be kind to give that student advice. The one over there, sir. Quite, that one exactly. Indeed, I will tell her it is recommended. Go on. To dodge things, yeah, to avoid projectiles. Oh, jolly good. It's a pretty good tip, actually. Maybe I'll try it out this run only. Projectile avoidance run. Oh man. Okay, I got my favorite item. That item over there is absolutely worthless. And it was actually just made obsolete by the item I got that lets me destroy objects. Basically what it does is it fires 3 projectiles that destroy objects, but do like no damage whatsoever. Oh man, I hate electricity. It's an ironic thing to say over the internet. Aw, man. Pretty much all the damage I'm taking lately is just from tokens. Alright, this should be easy. I should probably fight the boss before I use the vending machines from now on, cause that'll make it so I have more items, or damage actually. I still dislike you even though now I'm using your own item, the projectiles. I don't know, I guess he's not as bad as Leafy Oversight though. Most of my damage is just been from like rolling at them. They see me rolling, dancing, patrolling, and trying to catch me riding dirty. I've had a boss that that's given me health before. Fun thing I can do now is destroy those things. Alas, poor Yorick. So I don't know what's the difference between plus 50 experience and doubles. I think doubles is better. Because if you have like 100% experience, plus 50 is 150, but if you doubles, you have 200. And there's no vending machine. Whatever. I think that furniture object I just destroyed was one of the ones the spiky balls could not. So I don't know what... Oh man. Dude, that would have hit me if I didn't have that upgrade. Today, I'm just gonna go for the boss. Might as well, you know. Oh man, did I just one-shot that guy? I have never seen this item, so it might screw me over. Oh, that's the one I just unlocked from donating to the guidance counselor so much. Oh man. Oh my. Are you serious right now? Alright, Reagan, time for your annoying boss fight. I'm probably just gonna roll at you a bunch. I don't know why, but sometimes I get like the fire like every time, and like I never get anything else. And then sometimes like she starts up and she just does random ones. That's the hardest one to dodge is when you do like that, and you switch sides when she's in the middle of casting the fire move. I mean, main Reagan. I shouldn't be talking during this fight, but I'm doing pretty okay. Aw, oh, man. That was lucky AF that she did not turn there. I hate the way ice freaking shatters in this game. Like, if you hug a wall, you should be safe. Wow. Alright, final phase, guys. It's freaking electricity is so much. The only saving grace is that she doesn't do any fire attacks. All she does is, like, some fire on the floor. Man, like, two episodes ago or something, I was freaking fighting that boss, and I was just like, this is impossible to do, and without the things, juice boxes. And then I get here and I'm just like doing it without juice boxes, all cool like. It could be my items or it could be my skill. I worry about that brick pile sometimes. The brick pile that makes all those scraping noises? Yes. The one that dances around at night? Yes. The one that hurls its bricks at the building? Yes. Everyone's worried about the brick pile. Well, I think that was a really good use of my time to listen to that conversation. Oh man. I don't know if you guys hear it, but like the sound of you hitting the shield is like really loud in my ears. Alright, what do we get? This thing I want. That's how we spend money, boys. Let's see. Let's see how ridiculous we are now. Ah, just wonderful. So that added 20 crit will be really good in conjunction with that crit class I've enrolled in. Which is like the permanent unlocks is the different classes. I probably just lost a lot of damage, ironically. Well, let's see, that'd be around 50, so... yeah, that's actually a lot of damage to lose. But I'm sure we'll run into tokens as we go on. I always seem to luck my way out of stuff. I don't know why his desks were translucent there. They shouldn't have been. So here's an interesting strategy for how to dodge that. I don't know if you guys caught it, but you can slow-mo or whatever. It's pretty glorious. Oh man. Alright, and I got some HP. So, the Dolly Sexton I got back there is the one that makes your shots go in random directions after they're done. That synergizes really well with another item that I hope I can show you guys that makes it so it reflects off walls. If I can get that, it'll be pretty broken. Aw, poor guy stuck in the wall, he didn't even get to shoot at me. Alright, you need to stop. It's time to stop. Only good thing about this room is that that furniture is kind of a piece of cover. I'll shoot my own cover, I don't care. Ah, this is a fester cluck right here. I think the other one said. Kind of astonishing that none of those hit him. I don't think you ever really use Dolly Sexton on purpose to kill someone. It's more just an added extra thing. That's pretty useful. Oh my. Ah, boosted. I've got plus 6 dodge. And that's all I have except for. Oh, dodge is 21. It says up here. I never noticed that. It says stuff like damage. So I have 72 tokens, so I'd have 72 less damage. Ah, man, this is hard to decide. So this one... I'm not sure what leader this is. Oh man. I'll be honest. Oh wait. If this applies to rolls, it's really good actually. I was going to say something about it being useless because I never use chalk, but then I was like, my rolls use chalk. Oh my. Alright, that's cool. Alright, looks like he's going up. Going up, up in a merry-go-round. Sugarware going down swinging. Be a number one with a bullet. A loaded gun complex, cock it and pull it. We're going down, down. Man, this guy is taking me on a trip. He's gonna go up, isn't he? Dude, I am the guy that predicts things. Except for where that guy's coming from, because I did not see that coming at all. He was there for literally one hit before he teleported away. Like, another one? Is this one too big or something? I don't think there was. Well, actually, there might have been a couple that were too big there. Plus 45, that's the doctor's note, guys. Alright, yeah, I was like, he's gotta do something here. Not another fight, okay, cool. This is just basically free money as well as some lore, which I will check out in a second. Get hyped. Why me? The magician asked. Why do you think he'd target me? Complete the game on hard mode. So we're on chapter 4. It's pretty far. Why me? Do you think he'd target me? I only bought the sculpture yesterday, and again, you've seen the house, we're the only ones here. He spread his hands again, and three cards appeared on the table. Shuddering Jim and the chief rolled their eyes at each other. An insect buzzed somewhere overhead. Please, please, you are my guests, the magician said. Allow me to show you one more trick. It's called the Three Prisoners. He gestured to each card in turn. The strong one, the pretty one, and the quiet one. So the strong one's Goneril, the pretty one's Reagan, and the quiet one is me, Cordy. I'm pretty certain. The lamps on the wall flickered. Beware the third, she's always the ringleader. He reached to flip the first card, but before he had touched it, a strange thump arose from the far corner of the room. Turning around, Jim saw the drawing room behind them was still empty, except for a pair of houseflies. They seemed to be moving in perfect unison in the air. A mirror, he said. The henchmen are using a giant mirror. He ended the magician's trick prematurely by throwing the table, shattering the reflective glass. Oh, I get it. It's a pair of houseflies. There's really one, but it's being reflected. That was kinda slow of me. I still don't know if I can beat this guy or not. It's pretty hard. I mean, I know I can beat him, but like, can I beat his slimes, you know? Remember, kids, that's how you dodge attacks. Just get hit by them. So next time someone's throwing stuff at you, just run into it and you'll dodge it. This works 100% of the time. Ah, no, I already failed. Dang it. Do you see how many there are? Like, it's gotta be possible, but I don't know how. Ah, that was ridiculous. I'm in such a bad position. Why can't I get into a good spot? I was able to keep this badge from reaching him. And you're dead. You are dead. I like it how his projectiles kill themselves when he dies. That's a nice little touch there. I'm really confident in this run. I have 11 juice boxes. Like, even if we get Leafy Oversight and one of the harder, later game ones, like, we'll still be fine. Because I have my refill. Ah, this room's kind of annoying. You can just make little dodges. That's the trick to these. kind of interesting having the destructive ability. It reminds me of, oh my god. I was gonna say Space Invaders, and then my space got invaded. But, can I walk this way? Yeah, I totally can. I was gonna say Space Invaders, but then my space got invaded. Dude, watch. Watch. Aw, man, that is sweet. I know, I'm spending all my money and I shouldn't be. I should be saving it up for damage, but... You know, Stake will put me at pretty much full. And, Disquieting Drought is just always a good idea. It's just always a good idea, honestly. Like any of them. It's always good to have. Alright, I can juke this. Man, look at this floor. It's such a weird layout. I don't know what up with that. Was there any chest on this floor? I don't think there was any challenge room or anything. Anyways, here we go, folks. Into the upstairs. And it's a buoyant double, so... It already told us. What the... Bruh. I don't know what the red version of this will do. MP Lodestone, it looks like. It looks like I can't kill this Pots and Pans robot. Oh wait, does he get stunlocked if I go to the wall? That's Inkwell, it doesn't do anything, it just takes away, like, vision. So it's actually the opposite of what we want. You know what? I gotta say, I was resistant to the -2 health but extra tokens at first. But, like, that's a really good item. It's really helped me out here. That was a waste. I should have saved that. I'm sorry, guys. I'm boosted. Well, looks like we got another shot. I think this is a one run. And I don't just say that like Northern Line. Nah, I like Northern Line. I haven't seen him in a while. Yeah, let's just go for it. I think I already got the achievement for this guy, so I don't have to worry about anything. Gotten some good shots there, which is always nice. No homing shots in this game. Oh my god, dude. I don't know why I thought I could dodge that, but like it just moves not like too fast, but just like at a strange pace to what I'm used to. If you guys know what I mean. Ah, that was pretty sweet though, right there. Gotten a bunch of good shots. Oh man. I guess all bosses, when they die, their projectiles disappear. That's just something I never really noticed. So I have 2 juice boxes, so... That's pretty ridiculous. According to a bunch of the people that I'm reading about in business, they'd like it if making a profit physically hurt people. Cause they're all, well not all of them, but most of them are like, retailers are the devil, but they are a necessary evil. Like, I mean, what's your problem, dude? I mean, I understand their argument, like, retailers are just people that take goods from the people that make them and then sell them for a profit. But there was this one guy that like actually sympathized. Ah, man. Wow, this is just like ridiculous luck, honestly, with the items I'm getting. Aw, man, there's another one? But with nothing good. This item straight up has like hurt me so bad. Because it gives you electricity, right? And the thing is that the stuff when I roll, like, the musical notes and the chalk clouds and the bubbles, all those trigger the drums. But I have control over all those functions, right? But with the electricity, what basically happens is it just randomly says, alright, now I'm going to trigger. And, like, when it does, it triggers the green drum, and then it, like, half-heals me. But I probably don't need to worry about that, considering how far into the game I am. Still, though, I just really dislike that item. But not to the point where I won't pick it up. It's not like the ink thing we just passed by. Come on. There we go. The ink thing, it just makes everything darker, but it, like, increases your range. But I don't feel like that's an even trade-off. Oh, what are you doing, man? What's even happening? Is this a gluttonous floor? It might be, and I just, like, forgot. And if that's the case, I guess I'll go use this juice box. Wait, what? Ah, the guy healed me. Alright, whatever. I'll just take damage twice. Oh, man. That's pretty sweet there. This item right here, Norman's Inkwell. Just straight up garbage. Oh, so I guess this one wasn't actually the upper levels, but this one. Alright, get ready for my story time, boys. The staircase ahead leads to a library floor. Before the disappearance, these areas were strictly off limits to students. It's said that the creaking bookcases above can rearrange themselves, and that menacing things stroll through the stacks. Only one Edgewick student ever requested library books from her teacher. Apparently, those requests were honored, doubtless due to an outdated contractual requirements in the school's charter. Inky liquid drifts down the steps ahead, suggesting that your caring friends may be waiting for you. Perhaps they really did come here through a chalkboard accident of the Capulets, or maybe they were invited by a higher presence. Or perhaps they are simply a result of your rather uninspired imagination. Who can say? You can ask them. If you're not incinerated in one of their void zones first. So I have a feeling that my caring friends aren't actually my caring friends. Like, I don't know where I'm getting that from. But my friends seem to be like Reagan, and I just kill her. And Goneril repeatedly. Man, I am... This is like just such a clusterfuck right here. Like, do you see this, guys? This is ridiculous. Honestly, I wish I had Sudsy's ice tray right now. Yeah, attack speed. Ah, look at how beautiful that is. So, a trick to this guy, I think I said it before, is just staying horizontal. I'm just gonna go for the boss. I feel like the likelihood of... Wait, are those guys? Oh, I finished this room. Aw, man. These items, just the way that they mix together is insane. Alrighty then. Aw, shit, this is the one from last time. Chalk it up. Chalk it up to my imagination. Oh, fuck. Last one was just tragic. Aw, man, right when I started to do some damage, too. Wow, why was that so easy? Oh my gosh, guys, my heart rate. Okay. Okay, give me a second. That was, like, I'm stronger now, but, oh man, that first time, like, this is a scary boss. Several years ago, a dormitory of Edgewood students began to suffer from what appeared to be a collective nightmare. Multiple children described a dream in which they wandered through a great hall filled with statues of their peers. While minor details differed, all complained of a terrible sense of foreboding. As the hysteria spread, many begged for transfers to other part of the building. Further inquiry came to a halt when the dormitory itself and all of its inhabitants vanished. The groundskeepers assigned to clean the bunks found only an empty wall where the door had been the day before. The administrators referred to this as a unique, unpredictable, and tragically unavoidable occurrence, and have refused to connect the phenomena to similar dormitory disappearances in the past, or to the growing collection of lifelike statues in the library. So, wait. My move speed is pretty high, 300. Administrators, there's a statue in front of you with the door at the top. It looks ominous. You've no idea how much damage you've done this high. Coming this high, can you feel it in the bones of the school, from the crackling that echoes up from below the cellars, from the way that the building sways from side to side? You believe that you are capable of mercy, that you are only defending yourself. Instead, you are going to destroy us all, and you're going to hurt someone else, someone you've never met very badly. Could it be Shuddering Jim? Let's find out. You've always scared us more than the other two, initially because you were the worst, now because you've changed. Ah, get out of here, guy. This was not the correct direction to take. Whoa, what? Dude, I got scared by my own fireball projectiles. That's next level. Scaredy cat. Once, fun fact, I scared myself because I knocked over a book and then forgot about it. Alright, we're doing so well. I mean, if there's another boss after it, I feel like we should be able to take him. As long as there isn't some bullshit insta-death like, that fellow that we just fought, the statue guy. Administrator. This is the final boss of the game. Why? I felt like I hit him before that. I guess the portal is very small window. Alright, where are you? Chalk boys! Get chalked. Oh, there it is. This is such a fluster click right here. Oh my god, dude. Looks like it's the middle one. Oh, I get it. Like, every time you hit a wrong portal, someone spawns. Which is really bad if you have some ridiculous range like I do. You're dead. I don't care if you're the last boss in the game, you're dead. Not thinking with portals? Oh man, alright, here's hoping I don't die, cause most of the time I do. Floor 11 complete. The administrator melted into the floor and a moment later writing papers filled the room. Cordy leapt and rolled, trying to dodge the pages that threatened to envelop her. "What have you done with the teachers?" she asked, shouting to make herself heard over the wrestling. The administrator's answer seemed to come from the building itself. "The teachers? You dare ask what we have done with the teachers?" Now books were detaching themselves from the wall. A heavy volume caught Corky in the shoulder, almost knocking her down. "We have no idea what happened to them," the voice said. "Something destroyed them and ruined us all. They are similar to us and with the same responsibility. One task that they accomplished through kindness, and we accomplished through fear, which is to keep you inside." Corky threw herself down to the ground to dodge a bookcase. After the voice went quiet, all the papers and books drifted to a stop. She looked up to see an elegant wooden staircase unfolding from a trapdoor in the ceiling. Is the run over? Holy shit! Ah, this is sweet. The paper vortex, boss, his natural defenses. As you climb the staircase, you can feel the school disintegrate away beneath you. The trapdoor to the roof has a simple inscription carved into the wood. A vigilant mind endures all. So I'm not sure if I'll have to... Oh, fuck. I'm not sure, Wait, he was a crab the whole time? Wait, can I dodge this? Like... Chalk cloud. Oh, there we go. Oh, this is perfect. Oh, man. I'm not sure if I have to kill him or not. The trash can. Aw, man, a globe guy. So this is cool. This is kind of like a little compilation of all the different guys we fought before. All in one. I should probably kill the globe guy. I thought I did already, though. Whoa, this boss, dude. Oh my god. This is insane. This is literally insane. Alright, last chalk cloud. I don't know where Globe Guy is, but he's annoying me. Wait, what? Oh my god. Alright, I just need to remember to dodge. That is the most important thing to do right now. Wait, is he dead? This is such a cool final boss, though. Like, he might have a second phase. If he does, I think I can take it. Holy shit, in under an hour, reward new lesson? The announcement, the speed test? Okay. The end. Floor 12 complete. As the paper creature dissolved around her, Corky found herself walking back through the library. She was no longer in control of her actions. There was a crowd surging through bookcases towards the staircase, hundreds of Corky stepping carefully over the scattered books and paper. They covered the floor. They streamed in from each of the floors, covered in bramble from the terraces, and stained from the kitchens, descending towards the entrance. Not one of them spoke. As she reached the front door, she could see that they had ripped down the gate. They were spreading across the countryside, more than could have possibly fit in the school and still more behind her. The voices she heard seemed to be coming from somewhere else. Someone was laughing in a kind of choking or repetitive way, almost like crying. There was a distant shouting, and another voice kept saying, "Hold him, and test this, and it's over." But the laughing person couldn't stop. I have a few questions. I wonder if I have to equip this to get a true ending. So what do I get rid of? Yeah, that was three, because this one's one. And then, So... next episode, that's gonna be terrifying, but I feel like it's probably required for some sort of true ending, or at least a couple of unlocks. Oh, I should probably, I don't know, this seems easier. 20 plus crit chance, critical hit Sumor. I wonder if hard mode has less tokens. So, I have officially beaten the game, and I still do not have every item. Let's look at, my achievements. 64% achievement completed. For some reason, my taskbar is empty when I'm recording. Well, anyways, this was fun as hell, and I am happy. That was insane. See you next time.